So, as I told you, my colleague from an OpenStack environment has executed already this script, this command, in order to create a compute, to create a virtual machine based on the image used in the AGI fed cloud. And actually is instantiating this virtual machine using as contextualization script the file userdata.txt. So the machine is already available, and its address no, it's not here. SSH. Mario if you 71 no 75. So the contextualization file already contains the, my own public key, so I can connect directly to the machine and just providing the SSH future gateway with the IP address of this machine. So I can connect, and now I'm a future gateway user. The contextualization script operates on behalf of root user, so it's better at the moment to change the user. And now I'm a root. And you can see in this root space, I have the created install FG file, the one created by the contextualization script, the FG setup file downloaded from GitHub, and then the file installation error and installation out. In those files, you can watch them. In this moment, with the, sorry for I placed. In this moment, the installation is in the phase of packaging updating, so it's very at the beginning. Installation takes a while, so if I can use another one if the installation takes too long. Give him time, I can say other things. Go back again as a future gateway user. Inside this directory, there is this flag file, installing FG. This file will exist until the installation is not accomplished. So as soon as the installation finishes, this file will be not here anymore. So this is a flag that helps me to understand if the machine is ready or not. Go back to root user. And I think we can switch to the other machine because it is still on packages. The other machine was 48, isn't it? So this machine is exactly, has been installed exactly like the one currently installing. We can go back to it when later. We can do some practice with this. For instance, you can ask for the service status. So both components are running. The front end the service script execute the front end in as a command line execution, and this happens inside the screen section. So if I perform screen minus ls, I can see that there is a running screen section. I can connect to it. And you can see some messages coming from the API server front-end. I can stop it, for instance, and see the current configuration. So for instance, API server logconf. No, this is the logconf. Sorry. So I want to see if the token is disabled. In order to work without token management, just place this variable true. So no token is valid. So, and this is the default user that will use the front end to map the default user. So without when I don't specify a token. I can start again the so if I want to run the front end as a in a standalone, I can use directly this. So this tells me that the process is running, and this is the configuration loaded. I can detach from this screen section. And for instance, I can try to do some query. For instance, I can try to get the list of tasks. The tasks are empty because at the moment I'm mapped as a future gateway user. So if I, for instance, I reattach to the screen, this is shown by this message. So at the moment I'm a future gateway. There are no tasks at the moment on the database belonging to future gateway, but there are some tasks inside. So if I want to see other people's tasks, as I explained in the API slides, what I need is to specify user minus equal test. For instance, let's see user the tasks belonging to the test user. You can see I'm getting a huge list. Huge, it's not so big. And for instance, I can show you the use of the JQ command. And filtering out only the IDs. So available tasks ID in the queue table are only 1, 2, 6, et cetera, et cetera. If I want to get information of a specific job, I can specify the task number. So for instance, the 14th. And here you are the details about this execution. So I know that the task has a status done. It is a hello world. And here is the output file, the error file, etc. Let's try to, for instance, submit a job. I'm searching in the history, because it would be nice to recover. Okay, this is an example I can use. This is unnecessary. So I'm telling that I'm sending a application JSON, and the JSON is application one, that is the hello world. And here, description, hello world, I would like to change the name just to make a practice here. Localhost, test run. I can place here Sci-GaIA somewhere. This is enough to execute a job. You can see the status is submit. Now, so the task ID is 15, so I can use SDB command utility to watch the status. As you can see, the status in the database is already done. So if I perform a description, so the status is already done because it is executing on the same machine, so it's really fast. If I want to get the output of this execution, I can use the same command, curl, blah, blah, blah. And instead of using the tasks, I can provide the same content provided by URL to this prefix. And here you are, the output of the hello world execution. I can, for instance, delete the task. I can place here this last task. 15. Ah, sorry. I tried to remove an application. Okay. The message is that I successfully removed the application. If I do the same query on the database, 15 is still here. Why? Ah, okay. You can see I placed the request on the queue. So the delete is just placing on the queue the request I want to remove everything, any reference. And this will be processed by the daemon. The daemon is processing it. I think already processed it. And as you can see, you don't see any reference about the task with ID 15. The same using the get command, task 15. Exactly, you get an error. You shouldn't get this, by the way. I can fix this. You should get that the task doesn't exist. Later? With applications. You can get from this command the list of available applications. We can use again the JQ. Application.id. Okay, we have installed five applications. If I want to get the information about the application four, this is the details related to Application 4 is a hostname test. The target executor is the grid engine, etc., etc. So normally, future gateway components are under directory future gateway. You can reach this place also by this environment variable. And going inside the front end, we have other directories. In particular, you have this apps directory. So for instance, the first time you install the baseline installation, you can try to test Hello World. So you can cd inside this directory. And you can see this readme file that explains what to do. There are a few instructions. But there is also this stresstest.sh script. This is a script that contains everything to submit this example. Please pay attention on the count of the number of submission you want to execute. And this is another parameter, how many seconds you want to wait from one submission to with another one. There are also settings to manage the tokens, but those are not used. And those are, this is the script that performs the operation for you. So the first time you can directly try to execute the stress test SH. And this tells you that, again, you have the task with ID 15 and the submission has been finished. This means that the API server took your request and the job is running. Again, let's try to get the list. Okay, the job is already done. It was really fast. What about installation of new applications? For instance, you can use other installations. For instance,
can we see the output of the job that has been completed?
The output of the job is available here already. If you want to get it through the APIs, you have to take it, this content, prepare this call, okay, till now, till version.1, paste this. You need with the curl to place the semicolons, and ask, do this get a request? And you get the output. The output of this file is this one. There is an internal and alternative way to get this information. You can use the database. You can get information about this task, from this information of the queue. And you can get a path here. Inside this path is a temporary directory, a directory created at the moment of the submission, and this directory contains all the information related to this task. You can go, for instance, inside, or maybe we can do a find on this directory. And you see, for instance, the JSON file that is the task description in JSON format, the output directory where you can find all the output files. For instance, the content of the output files we have seen before is this file highlighted here. So if I do a cut of this, I got the same content. And so on. But, This is another JSON file that is using the grid engine component, but this is not important for our scopes, actually. So in order to talk about installation, you can, for instance, try to use as a template this script, setup application. Amber, Docker, Amber, Tosca, several of those application names you see here in this apps directory are available on GitHub as well. So if you want to prepare your own installation script, application installation script, you can take this setup app SH script, and you can try to customize it accordingly to your specs. I think there exists a better one. I'm afraid it's on Git. Applications.